Djebali, DJ producer, run its own label. Djebali is fan of Kerry James. True. Studied in engineering. Everything is right. Djebali. Of course, not DJ Bali. No. After. Finish your sentences. Breakfast in Ibiza, lunch in Paris, and dinner in Marseille. I think it was a post I did this summer. Do you remember your very first gig in Paris? Yes, I played a lot in bars where I have to bring my own equipment. But my first gig in a real club, it was in Nouveau Casino. It was for an after party of Terence Terry. And it was called After Party Is Not a Crime. And it was a long time ago. I don't remember when, probably beginning of the next century. Bah. What's on your rider? It's mostly technical, turntables, CDJs, and also a little bit of tequila. You are about to launch a new series of digital tracks to download for free. Can you tell us more about it? Yes, I wanted to do it. It's a new project. It's gonna be a series of free download of tracks, one track every month, and it's gonna last 12 months, so 1 year. And the purpose is to give the opportunity to people who don't have access to vinyl or young people to sometimes it's hard to buy a new vinyl because it's a lot of money, of course, and you don't have access to record shop or whatever. So it's to give the opportunity for people to access to the music for free. And not on vinyl, so it's gonna be only digital on this series. Why do you prefer vinyl to USB and CD? I always booked vinyls when I was young. When I started DJing, it was more easy anyway to play on vinyl than USB and CD. But USB didn't exist, and CD was really complicated. So I always played vinyls. But it's not like I prefer the sound, but to play, I can play USB, CDs or vinyls, whatever the matter is the music who matters. What new equipment have you recently added to your studio? I added a sequencer called Circlon. Really, really good one. Rex Club is now celebrating its 30 years anniversary. You have your own residency there, Ideal Juice. Can you share with us one of your best memories? There is a lot of memories because it's been like now 4 years I do the residency. It's kind of, it's like one party every 2 months, 2 months and a half, so a lot of parties. One of the best, well, I remember this one with MCDE, Motor City Drum Ensemble. It was in August. And it was like so packed, like at the club is supposed to close around like 6 or 7, something like that. And at like 5 in the morning, it was still the queue outside. It was like totally crazy. It was a super, super nice party. How many vinyls do you have at home? More than 5,000. Festival or club? I'm a club kid, so I will say club. Dubstep or drum and bass? No idea. Maybe not that. Fine, no idea. Classical or jazz? Jazz. Yeah, definitely jazz. A lot of DJs are trying to get out of the grid and spend less time on social medias. What are your thoughts on this? I think it's really good, even if I do the totally opposite, to be honest. I spend like less time on Facebook, but much more on Instagram, so at the end it's the same. And it's like crazy, like you it's addictive, it's super addictive. And you finish to put likes on like a photo of your friends coming like eating a pizza at night or whatever, so it's kind of a little bit stupid, but it's so addictive that I should spend less time, but I can't. Your studio looks like a spaceship. Yeah. What's your favorite equipment? The one I booked recently called Circlon. It's a sequencer, like it's amazing the possibilities you have. And of course my MPC 3000, like it's the main thing of the studio. I do everything with it. What would be your dream back-to-back? Prince and Michael Jackson. Djebali went digital for the very first time in 2016. Tell us more about this choice.
Well, I went digital, but it's a little bit different. I mean, I released like a lot of vinyl-only thing, and so I took a bounce of tracks of these vinyls, and I did like some special edits, like I put like the track shorter, and I put it on digital to make it accessible for the people who can't afford vinyls or don't play vinyls or whatever, other people other than DJs. And so I released like, it was a compilation called Ilia Jules Compilation with 10 tracks. And it's the second one is about to be released, the part two, in March. So watch out.
Can you list as many Djebali artists as possible? Of course, Red Adair, Mr. KS, Livio and Robbie, Premier Scoop, Roscoe. The next one's coming. Which one? Chris Tussi, Swoy, Riza Mensoul, Cab Drivers, Tuchillo, a lot of more. Why did you create your offshoot label Djebali Presents? Because I received a lot of music from young DJs, young producers. And I was thinking like what you need the most when you're starting producing and everything, it's network. So I didn't want to create another label with like random people. So I wanted to make a series of like kind of newcomers or people who don't have a lot of experiences releasing and to connect them. So that's why each people who make a Djebali present, each artist making a Djebali present, you have to remix the next one. So like this, I can create like networking between the young artists. And I think that's the most important thing in the business.
What's your favorite spot in Ibiza?
I will say the sunset, to see the sunset in Hostal La Torre in the north of the island. Tell us a good DC10 story. There is this time that I was playing in the garden, it's outside. And the DJ who was supposed to, one of the DJ who was supposed to play in the terrace didn't show up because he missed his flight or whatever. So they tell me to replace him. So I played like a second set. Then the DJ after was supposed to play with his computer, and his computer didn't work. It didn't work. So they tell me to continue. And then he was supposed to play Set Rocks Club after me, and he shows up and he said, well, let's go back to back. So at the end, I played like more than 6 hours in DC10. So it was like a really nice experience.
What's the most annoying question frequently asked by journalists during an interview?
This one, exactly this one.
Blind test, play the record in front of you.
What can you tell us about this track? Well, this track, it's a remix I did for DJ Pierre. DJ Pierre, who is like also, he got his nickname called Wild Peach. He's like the godfather of High Seed House. And he's releasing his first album right now. It's a bunch of tracks he did in the past. And they asked me to do a remix. I was honored to do a remix for him, of course. And I'm really happy to be able to remix a classic of him. So, and I'm pretty happy of the result, to be honest. Each time I play it, I'm really excited. Choose fast, DJ set, live act, DJ set. Star Wars, The Lord of Rings. The Lord of Rings. House, techno, house, definitely house.
Berlin, Paris.
Paris, I'm a Parisian, so Paris.
Who would you love to collaborate with you on a track?
There is a lot of artists. I would say Matthew Johnson, for example.
Have you ever said never again after a party?
Yes, a lot. Too much. You've released the first part of the reworks of your album 5. Can you tell us more about it? And when is the next part coming out?
Yeah, the first part was just released now. It's remixes with Andres, like a fantastic remix, really housey, sunny remix, really good. And on the other side, it's another producer I love called Arapu, with more of a Romanian style, really, really great, with the super bass line, incredible. And the second part is gonna be released like next week, and it's gonna be feature Terence Terry and the master Satoshi Tomy. Like, I'm really proud to have all these four guys on this project. What's your plan for 2018? Well, I got a lot of release coming and a lot of parties. So my plan is like be concentrated and focused on that. I got a lot of remixes coming, and also a lot of, I'm really working a lot in the studio right now. So my plan is to release a lot of music. A last word, it's time to say goodbye. Oh no. Well, I had a lot of fun, and long life to the Beat Bad Bucks.